All right, so I am. Can I pass the story? Oh, it's fine. All right. So, welcome. This is part two of my first impressions on the Rogue Galaxy replay. If you watched the first video, kind of talked about how never really played this game because it was like one of the last games on the PS2 life cycle, so I never had the opportunity to play it. So I'm just still kind of in the first part right now.
Some sort of strategy. Here we go. Something's wrong here. There's just too many beasts. Here they come. Piece of cake. That was a cinch. I've never played this game before. I don't know if it's like, oh, am I able to come back here and pick up the treasure chest, which I'm assuming. Oh, excuse me. I'm assuming that I can, since it's not that I can't use this for.
Wait.
Huh?
Now we go our separate ways.
What? What do you mean?
I can't go with you anymore. Sorry. Just go into the residential area and take down that big brute.
Hey, hold on a second. I can't take that thing out by myself.
You don't think so? Here, try this. It's much better than that butter knife of yours. And this.
What's this?
A battle recorder. It'll capture the fight from start to finish. You ought to get a lot of points for bagging that fella. Go on, take it with you. See you later.
No, wait! How can you just leave me here? Damn it. Fine. You can't scare me. Bring it on, fellas. Here we go.
Quick. Well, apparently I wasn't paying attention to my health meter. Alright. Well, let's see. I assume most of these role-playing games, they just take you back to your, either take you back to the main menu, or they'll just take you back to the last, yeah, take you back to the main menu. Just gotta keep. Alright. So I'd have to do this over again. About the button configuration.
Don't fall behind, okay?
You know, I'm so used to like square being the attack button, but on here it's X. You know, and I would probably think like if I had a jump button in battle, it would be the X button, but that apparently is not necessarily the case. You know, just a lot of different, buttons I'm not used to, but this would have been common in the PS2 era, where those buttons would have been more.
Wait.
Huh?
Now we go our separate ways.
What? What do you mean?
I can't go with you anymore. Sorry. Just go into the residential area and take down that big brute.
Hey, hold on a second. I can't take that thing out by myself.
You don't think so? Here, try this. It's much better than that butter knife of yours.
Here we go.
Oh,
You're not half bad, kid!
Huh? Oh my! Could it be?
Steve-O, what's going on?
Just look!
Come on, what is it?
Yes? There's no doubt about it. And see what he's got there? That's Desert Claw's weapon, Desert Seeker, one of the seven sacred galactic swords.
So that means that you must be... the legendary hunter, Desert Claw!
The what?
Oh, I can't believe how lucky we are to think we found him this quickly.
No kidding!
I told you he'd be on this planet, didn't I? Didn't I? See?
Well now, aren't we the lucky ones? Mission accomplished. Let's head on back. Come on, come on. You too, mister.
Whoa. Wait a second. What are you trying to do? Look, I've got to take care of that beast up there. You're in my way.
Ah, why bother? I mean, it's such a chore. Come to our ship, and we'll give you all kinds of sweet jobs that beat the pants off plain old beast hunting. Come on!
Knock it off! I have to go now, or that thing is gonna destroy the town! Let me go!
That's our Desert Claw, a man of unbending determination.
Ah, whatever you say. We'll accompany you on your hunting trip, but when this little escapade's over, you're coming with us. Is that a deal?
Huh? Why should I?
Then it's settled. Let's be on our way.
Here they come.
Are you ready?
A weird.
That was a cinch.
Waste of time. The residential area is in a load of trouble.
Challenge at all. Courage and foolhardiness are not the same thing.
Here they come, bunch of weapons.
Over.
The beasts, go for the big one.
The residential area is beyond here.
Gosh, he's not a quiet fella, is he? Must be rather large as well.
You're not planning on having all three of us go in there, are you?
You want to fight them all by yourself?
No, not at all. That's crazy, totally reckless.
You know, Mr. Claw, I think you forfeit any points you earn if you, die.
Yeah. Let's go.
Hey, wait up!
Poor kid. We hardly knew him.
There it is.
That is certainly a big monster, all right.
Are you positive about this, Mr. Claw?
Like I have a choice.
Whoa, this thing is huge.
Watch you don't get crushed.
Supposed to do that?
Jump on its back and hack away. Isn't it obvious?
Are you nuts? There's no way.
Hang on. I've got just the thing for this kind of situation.
What's that?
I'll tell you later. Watch this.
What the?
That's my monography shot. What do you reckon? Do you like it? Jump on the back of those monography platforms and you can get up on the back of the beast. Here you go, big man. Why don't you take this for now? When the platform disappears, just shoot up another one. But remember, you must equip the monography shot first before you can use it.
Now's your chance. Go get him, Mr. Claw!
Did that do it?
Nope.
I'm afraid not.
But you're almost there. Is the battle recorder ready? That kind of beast will net you heaps of points. Make sure you get it all on tape.
What? You mean this?
Oh, now that is a well-used recorder.
Use that to record your battle with the beast, and later on you can turn it in for points. Now finish off the beast by yourself. After all, it's your prize.
All right. And here goes.
Its heart has stopped, but it's still being controlled by the power of the rune. Destroy the rune in its head.
Oh, come on. Like a legendary hunter needs your help.
I get the feeling he sort of does. I wonder why. Is he really Desert Claw? I suppose looks can be deceiving.
A real master doesn't need to show off. He may not look it, but he's got the goods.
Just as I thought, his potential may be greater than my own.
So listen, Mr. Claw, you got a real name or something?
Huh? Huh? Oh yeah. I'm Jaster. Jaster Rogue.
Jaster, eh? Good. It's a bit weird to keep calling you Desert Claw. So from now on, if it's all right with you, I'm just gonna call you Jaster, okay?
Now, let's get down to business. I'll be straight with you. Our boss says he wants to hire you. Would you come with us?
Hire me? What? Why me?
Good grief, isn't it obvious? You're Desert Claw, the legendary bounty hunter. And our boss, well, he wants to be a part of that. Let's just say he's scouting you for our team.
These guys still think I'm someone named Desert Claw. That means he must be Desert Claw. I had no idea he was such a big deal.
What is it, Jaster? Are you feeling all right?
Yeah, I'm fine. So who is it that wants to hire me, exactly?
Our boss, Captain Dorgan Goa, a pirate among pirates.
What? Dorgan Goa? The space pirate Dorgan Goa? You mean, you guys do space travel?
Of course. We're big-time pirates. We travel all over the galaxy. I mean, hunting has its moments, but tracking down immense treasure throughout the universe isn't half bad.
Me. Up in space. Yeah, I can see that. Not half bad at all.
Our ship is hidden in the desert to the west of here. Why don't you meet up with us there?
In the desert?
Well, you know, we had a couple of minor issues, and we couldn't actually dock at the spaceport. But look, we'll head back to the ship first. You come meet us there before tomorrow morning. All right? All right. Ta-da!
Hey, wait a minute. I haven't decided yet.
Oh, you'll be there, all right. I can see it in your eyes. You were made for the pirate life.
To find our ship, you need to take the west gate and head straight over the desert. Please be sure to prepare for your journey before setting out. We'll be seeing you later. Ta-ta!
Thank you.
I can go to space. How am I gonna tell Raoul? Captain Dorgan Goa, huh? Space pirates. Are they really?
Oh.
I'll take you on. No big deal. That was a cinch. Captain Dorgan Goa, huh? Ooh. I wonder if they'll ever realize I'm not Desert Claw. Space pirates. Are they really? Here they come. We're not done yet. No challenge at all. Captain Dorgan Goa, huh? Captain Dorgan Goa, huh? Looks like there's no damage here. Space pirates. Are they really?
Sounds like things have calmed down out there.
Yeah. But it was a bit more tough than usual.
I'm glad you're okay.
Me too. But listen, Raoul.
What is it?
Never mind.
What's going on, Jester?
Raoul, I'm really grateful. You found me abandoned on the church steps and raised me to be who I am today.
What's all this about? Are you okay? Did you hit your head?
Well, I'm heading out.
All right.
I wonder if they'll ever realize I'm not Desert Claw. Captain Dorgan Goa, huh? Was outside the western gates, right? I'll take you on. That's how you get it done. Looks like there's no damage here. Captain Dorgan Goa, huh? Here they come! This is what you get! That's the end of that! I wonder if they'll ever realize I'm not Desert Claw. Space pirates. Are they really? Thank you.
interesting as far as how everything works in that respect.
Jester.
Raoul, what are you doing here?
Thought you could just leave without saying anything?
I'm sorry. I didn't want you to try to stop me.
Me? Stop you?
I want to leave this planet and travel through space. I want to see new things and learn about this vast galaxy we live in. It's been my dream since I was little. Come on, Raoul. What do you say? I'm sorry, Raoul. Thank you so much for raising me and taking care of me. Well, I'm off.
Wait. I always knew this day would come. Do you remember when you were just a boy? We'd always look up at the stars together.
Yeah. Of course I remember. We'd gaze up at the stars and talk about outer space.
You know, Raoul, I've made up my mind. I want to go into space one day.
Really? And what would you do out there?
Huh? Well, I don't know. I don't know, but I still want to go, for sure. Can I, Raoul? Huh? Can I?
Of course you can, Jester. You can do anything you want.
Uh-huh.
Right now, your eyes are shining just like they were back then. Self-assured, straightforward eyes. I don't think I could stop you if I tried. Go, Jester. But I want you to remember something. You're the only family I've got. From the moment I first held you, a crying little baby, 17 years ago, I've come to think of you as my son. And that, my boy, will never, ever change.
Raoul.
I'll be waiting here for your return. I'm sure it'll be a little lonely.
Raoul. Someday, I'm gonna save everyone on this planet. I can't let Rosa remain in slavery forever.
Then I'll stay here, hoping and praying for your success. Take care of yourself, Jester.
Huh?
So that's Dorgan Goa's ship, huh?
And these full motion videos are really well drawn, and like even I said before.
And so comes the end of one long day. Come dawn, I'll be leaving this planet.
This game came out, so
something up there is waiting for me. I can feel it. And that's why I'm going into space. It's almost morning.
Hey, Chester! Over here, big man!
Hey! Whoa! What gives? What the?
Who are you?
Now that's what I call a close shave! Seeing monsters that big and ugly nearly sent me into a tailspin myself!
We didn't mean to leave you out there like that. We fully intended to come back for you later, I swear.
It doesn't matter. I got saved in the end. Listen, that girl back there...
You mean Kasala? Wow, you sure don't waste any time. That's Desert Claw for you.
Listen, though, don't you be getting any ideas, big man. To tell you the truth, she's...
So this is the guy.
The legendary hunter, Desert Claw.
Are you Captain Dorgan Goa?
Huh? Hey, Baldhead, set this kid straight.
Allow me to introduce Zegrim Gart, the Black Wolf. He's a bounty hunter handpicked by our boss, like you.
He's skilled, all right. But he's got a big gob on him. Says he's a lone wolf. I think he just doesn't have any friends.
I hate teaming up with small fries. Never expected Desert Claw to be such a youngster. Guess you can't trust rumors, can you? Anyway, nice to meet you, Desert Claw.
Hey! So you're Desert Claw?
Wait, you're...
The one and only First Mate Munsha!
Is the captain still napping? Oh, he can be such a pain.
Oh! The Desert Claw has a shrewd look about him. That's what the captain would have said. I'm sure of it. When the captain's not around, I'm the one in charge. And Desert Claw or not, you'd better follow orders. You got that?
Okay.
Excellent. Now that that's out of the way, you're an official crew member on the Dorgonok. All right. Now that we have the legendary hunter Desert Claw on our side, nothing can stop us! The treasures of the universe are ours for the taking!
Hey, Raoul, where's that ship going?
I'm not sure. Maybe to some planet somewhere.
Really? What do they have on other planets?
Well, all sorts of things.
Like what? What kind of things do you mean?
I've never been myself, so I don't really know.
Aw, Raoul, you're no fun.
I'm sorry about that. I happen to like this planet. As long as I can live here, I'll be satisfied.
Really? Then I want to go into space. I want to explore the galaxy and see what it's like out there.
Oh, really? I'm sure you will one day.
Yep, and I bet it'll be super cool. And when I come back, I'll tell you all about it, Raoul.
Well, I'm looking forward to that.
What's wrong?
It's nothing. So, what do we do now?
Oh, that's right. I forgot. Now we head for Zerard.
Zerard?
Goodness, haven't you heard of it? It's very advanced. The most civilized planet in the galaxy.
So, why are we going there?
We've got some important business there. Dorgonok, full speed ahead!
Aye-aye!
Your instructions will follow. Now, I've got some lunch to eat, so if you'll excuse me, I'll be seeing you all later. Meow!
You can take it easy too, Mr. Rogue. Perhaps you'd like to have a look around the ship while we're in transit.
Good idea. I mean, after all, this place is your home now, isn't it?
Thank you for watching. Have a good day.